Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and today we're continuing our daily video streak with this time another review on a set way too old to where it really shouldn't deserve a review. This time we're doing the Tron Lightcycle Chase, and it's a really great set. I'm not showing like everything in it. There's also this minifig right here, but I'm not gonna stall. Let's just get right into this video.
This is a pretty wonderful figure. The printing on it is top notch, if you can see it. So you can see that there is a mesh design printed in there. That is pretty hard to see, but it's pretty wonderful. And then you can see all the little blue streaks and lines that are very awesome. And also on her arm, she has, little spoiler, the ISO symbol, which if I can just get the camera to focus. You can kind of see it there. It's kind of hard to see on the minifigure anyways, but it's still amazing nonetheless. Comes with a little sword, even though she really only uses a sword about like once. It's got a nice printed face as the school bus comes by my house. And the face looks nice. It's got a nice hairpiece, and I do not believe, oh, there is another head print. And it all looks very wonderful. I do think that this side of the face captures the likeness of the actress much better. But nonetheless, still wonderful. And then I'm going to disable the figure, which is why you don't see it right now. That way you can see the back. Which again, does have some of that mesh printing on it. And it looks amazing. And then, as do all of the figures, they come with their discs. Hers looks just like Sam's, and Winslow's is just orange. And then it clips on using a very simple translucent piece. Then you put the head on, of course, all of the aggressive facial expressions, since that's how the video started. And then you put the hairpiece on, and you've got a pretty good figure, and I love it a lot. And for LEGO standards, it's pretty amazing. So let's move on to keeping with the idea of fully custom, not custom, but LEGO fully printing new designs. This is another amazing figure, and it's got little foot printing, which is always nice to see. So if the camera will focus, I will show you that he does also have the mesh design on his suit. Yeah, there you go, you can kind of see it there. And again, same little blue printing, just different from her design because he wears a different suit. Awesomely printed arms, and again, foot and leg printing, just like Korra. And then I like him with his helmet on, but he does come with a alternative hairpiece, and of course the alternative facial expression. And I don't think that it looks like perfect to the likeness of the actor, but it still does look pretty good, I think. And then on the back, of course, you have the identity disc, and then if I can just remove all of this to show what the back looks like. What it looks like. Again, the mesh design is there, and I think this is a pretty amazing figure by LEGO, and I don't think I would ever try to change any of these figures from this set. Amazing LEGO figure, and now let's go on to Rinzo, which is probably another amazing LEGO figure. So I know I've been raving on and on about all these figures, and for Rinzo, it's no different. So as you can see, he has a nice print on him that really does give off his amazingly detailed suit, and there is of course the mesh design, if the camera focus, so you can sort of see that there. It's all over the place and it looks amazing. There is no arm printing on this figure, but I think that it's fine. They use the Invincible Iron Man helmet for him, and I think it works pretty well. It's got a nice print and it's molded in black. And then just the average face, it's nothing special, but you don't really see the actor too many times, and when he says Rinzo, you don't see it at all, so I don't think it matters. And then to connect the two identity discs, it is equipped with this little back bracket, and then of course it has the two orange identity discs, which are the same as the blue ones, just in orange. And then the back also has printing, again with that mesh design there. It's just, again, hard to see because there it is. But it looks very wonderful. The whole print on this figure is insanely detailed, and anybody who ever tried as a customizer to correct it would be foolish. The only way they really could have upped this figure, I just ran into something, is if they did arm printing, but I don't think they will ever do that. I got in. But it's fine, and now if you would just allow me to stall as I put the figure back together. So yeah, there's Winslow. Let's go ahead and take a look at the instruction manuals, the box, and then we will get on to the actual set itself. So usually I wouldn't show the instruction manual, but this one is just way too cool not to. It's got a great print on it. Of course, it says Tron Legacy and LEGO. Sorry, this is kind of a little too large for my studio. It has some things about the designers and everything. I'm not going to give you time to read. And then it has a little plot description and character description there. So that's fun. And then it has it in all the languages. A little explanation of how ideas works for LEGO Ideas. And then you can see it caps out at 72 pages and then has all the pieces listed. So yeah, it's definitely an instruction manual and it looks pretty cool. So now let's move on to the box. The box definitely exists, and I'm going to have to kind of make this shot a little different. I'm gonna pull up the camera real quick, where you can get a nice view of the top of the box. It looks very wonderful. It is the Ideas style box with the whole opens like this. I'm currently storing some instruction manuals in there. It's got ideas there. It's the 21st LEGO Ideas set. 10 plus, 230 pieces. Tron Legacy. All the things. And then explains the back of the set. Alright, now moving on to the builds. So I'm just going to kind of get these out of the way real quick. And we'll start with the little platform that they both come on. And the platform is very simple. It's supposed to look like the grid, I guess. And I think that it does a very good job of that. It can house two of the light cycles, the two that are provided. It's a very simple build, but it definitely gets the job done. Definitely a very cool thing to have for as a display piece, and I love it a lot. So now let's move on to the two identical builds that just have some colors swapped out, which are the two light cycles. So here's the blue one, which is Flynn's in this case. So I'm going to take him off his light cycle. It's very nicely detailed. The original design was done by the brothers Brick, and I really enjoyed it. It's got some printed light cycle rim pieces, and those are the only printed pieces besides the minifigures. There are no stickers in this set. And then I think that the whole design of it is also really wonderful, and I like how they use the translucent, I guess, banner piece as the light beam that comes out the back of it. And then it has a little area available for the minifigures, so I will just put, of course, Sam in here. And he can fit in there nice and well. There are little bars that aren't really good for minifigure hands, so I won't clip him in. But all in all, this is a pretty great little vehicle, and I really like it a lot. It definitely looks like a light cycle, and I think it's great. So let's move on to the orange one now, which I won't spend as much time on it, because it is the exact same thing, just an orange. And again, it looks really great. I will remove Rinsley. And it still has the printed rim pieces. It is built the exact same way, just where there are blue parts, there is now the orange. And again, everything that I said positive about the blue one goes to this one. It's still great. It still fits Winslow right here. And it looks amazing. And I love them. So let's go ahead and wrap up this video. So now the golden question. Should you buy this set or not? Well, if you're not a Tron Legacy fan, don't you dare buy this set. Because it is not worth it. It is $35 for 230 pieces. Even though the minifigures are amazing, that is outrageous. And the builds are also amazing. So if you are a Tron Legacy fan, I would say definitely pick this set up. I know it's been out for forever and it's probably not even on shelves anymore, but it's a pretty amazing set if you're a Tron Legacy fan like me. But if you're not, then don't buy it. It's not worth it. So now let's just go ahead and wrap this video up. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to let me know by dropping it a like below and or your opinion on the video, and make sure to subscribe as well and hit that bell for notifications. That way you are notified whenever more videos come out. I have no clue if there will be a video tomorrow, but you know, you gotta subscribe. Because if you do, then you'll know that there's a video tomorrow if it comes out. But that's it. Hopefully you enjoyed the review. And if you are a Tron Legacy fan, I would definitely say go pick this set up. It's pretty great. But until next time, as always, be positive.